upon them both so that the humankind could come. They were the great great grandparents. Allah says in Surah Hujurat, chapter number 49, verse number 13, Ya ayyuhan nasu inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa unsa wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila litarafu inna akramakum indallahi atqakum inna allaha alimun khabir. O humankind, we have created you from a single pair of male and female, and I've divided you into nations and tribes so that you may recognize each other, not that you may despise each other. And the most honored in the sight of Almighty God is the person who has taqwa. The criteria to judge any human being, it is not wealth, it's not color, it's not caste, it's not creed, it is taqwa, it is God consciousness, it is righteousness, it is piety. So Adam and Eve, peace be upon them both, they were our great great grandparents, of yours also and of mine also, all humankind. Therefore I call you a brother, we are brothers in humanity. Allah says, Ya you are nas, O humankind. And Allah says in Surah Isra, chapter number 17, verse number 70, وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَا. Almighty God has honored all the children of Adam. Whether they are born in India, USA, UK, born in a Hindu family, or a Muslim family, or a Christian family, Allah says He has honored all the Bani Adam. If you are a human being, Allah has honored you. Whether your name is Zakir, Abdullah, Ramu, Shankar, if you are born as a human being, Allah has honored you. Now coming to the question, why has Almighty God created the human beings? Allah has created the human beings because Allah says this is one of His best creation. All the other creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they obey Him. We have the angels. Whatever Almighty God says, the angels obey Him directly. They have no free will. The human being is the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which has a free will. We can either obey Him or disobey Him. So Allah has created such a creation. We are one of His best creation and the best of forms. But we have a choice of either obeying God or disobeying God. If we obey God, we will go to Jannah, we will go to Swarg, we will go to heaven. If we disobey Him, we'll go to hell. We'll go to Nark. So this is a test for the hereafter. Allah says in Surah Mulk, chapter number 67, verse number 2, Allazi khalaqal mauta wal hayata. It is Allah who has created death and life to test which of you is good in deeds. So this life is a test for the hereafter. So Allah has created the human beings, and Allah says in Surah Dhariyat, chapter number 51, verse number 56, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنْسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. That we have created the jinn and the men not but to worship Him. So we supposed to worship, obey the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a different creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which has the free will of even going against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or obeying Him. All the other things, the stars, the trees, the mountains, the Quran says they do sajda to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they prostrate to Him, they obey Him. We have a free will. Now when Allah has given a free will, with the free will if we obey Him, we become higher than the angels. With the free will if we disobey Him, we become the partners of the devil. So He's created us for the test for the hereafter. Coming to your second question. Everything has a creator. Who created? God. If anyone says everything has a creator, it is a wrong statement. Every created thing has a creator. The definition of God is, He is uncreated. The moment you say who created God, He's not God. The definition of God is He's uncreated. Suppose a person comes and asks you, that brother, my friend John, he was admitted in the hospital. He gave birth to a child. Can you guess, was it a girl or a boy? Can you guess? Try it out. Guess. Can't guess. Why? Can you on the microphone? Can you guess, was it a girl or a boy? Huh? See, brother John, he was admitted in the hospital. He gave birth to a child. Was it a girl or a boy? Can you guess? A 50% chance? Girl or boy? People are laughing. Why? Can you guess? Can't guess. Why? Even if you guess, can you get the answer right? Okay, can you guess? I'll give you two chances. Was it a girl or a boy? Try it out.
Girl.
Brother, can a man give birth to a child? There you made a mistake. Same way you made a mistake by asking who created God. A man cannot give birth to a child. So where's the question of it being girl or a boy? See, now you understood. Now that's good, brother. So it was a man cannot give birth to a child. So where's the question of a girl or a boy? So when you're asking who created God, God by definition, Allah by definition is uncreated. The moment you say who created Allah, He's not Allah. Walam yakul lahu kuffanat. There's nothing like Him. Coming to your last part of the question, who is Allah? Who is Allah? The best definition I can give you is quote to you Surah Ikhlas, chapter number 112, verse number 1 to 4. It's mentioned in the Quran, Kul ho Allahu ahad. Say he is Allah one and only. Allahu samad. Allah the absolute eternal. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. He begets not nor is he begotten. Wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. There is nothing like him. This is a four-line definition of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Any human being, any person says, so and so candidate is God. If that candidate fits in this four-line definition, we Muslims have got no objection in accepting that candidate as God. Four-line definition. This is the litmus test for theology, for the study of God. First is, Qul huwa Allahu ahad. Say is Allah one and only. Allahu samad. Allah the absolute and eternal. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. He begets not nor is he begotten. Wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. There's nothing like him. If you go to the Hindu scriptures, the same is mentioned in the Hindu scriptures. Qul huwa Allahu ahad is mentioned if you read Chandogya Upanishad, chapter number 6, section number 2, verse number 1. Ikkam evidityam. God is only one without a second. Second test. Allahu samad. Allah the absolute eternal. Bhagavad Gita chapter number 10, verse number 3 says, I am known as the Lord of all the worlds, the unbegotten, the beginningless. Third test. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. He begets not nor is begotten. It's mentioned in the Shvetashvatara Upanishad, chapter number 6, verse number 9. Nachasya kasij, janita na chadipa. Of him, there are no lords. He has got no parents. Almighty God has got no father. He has got no mother. And valam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad, there nothing like him, is mentioned in Shvetashvatara Upanishad, chapter number 4, verse number 19. And Yajurved, chapter number 32, verse number 3, where it says, Natasya Pratima Asti. Of that God, there is no Pratima, there is no idol, there is no image, there is no photograph, there is no sculpture. Who says that? Yajurved, chapter number 32, verse number 3. Same as valam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. So any person saying so and so candidate is God, if that candidate fits in the four-line definition, we Muslims have got no objection in accepting that candidate as God. For example, some people say Bhagwan Rajneesh is Almighty God. Well, during question answer time, a Hindu told me, we don't believe Bhagwan Rajneesh to be God. I never said that the Hindus believe Bhagwan Rajneesh is God. I said some people believe Bhagwan Rajneesh to be God. Let us put this Rajneesh to test. First test is, Qul huwa Allahu ahad. Say is Allah one and only. Was Rajneesh one and only? Was he the only man who claimed divinity? There are hundreds of them. And in this country, we have thousands of men who have claimed divinity. He's not the only one. But Rajneesh Bhakti said, no, he's unique. Let's go to the next test. Allahu samad. Allah, the absolute eternal. Was Rajneesh absolute eternal? We know from his biography, from his autobiography, he was suffering from asthma, from diabetes, from chronic backache. Imagine Almighty God suffering from asthma, diabetes, chronic backache. Third test. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. He begets not nor is begotten. Bhagwan Rajneesh was born in Madhya Pradesh. He had a father and mother. In 1981, he goes to America, USA. And he takes thousands of Americans for a ride. In the state of Oregon, he starts his center and calls it as Rajneeshpuram, his village. Later on, the American government arrests him and put him behind bar. Rajneesh says, the American government slow poisoned me. Imagine Almighty God being slow poisoned. In 1985, the American government kicks him out of the country. He comes back to India in the same city, Pune, and he goes back to his center, which is now called as Osho Commune. And if you go to the Samadhi of Rajneesh, it is mentioned there on the Samadhi, Bhagwan Rajneesh, Osho, never born, never died, but visited the earth from the 11th of December 1931 to the 19th of January 1990. Never born, never died, but visited the earth from the 11th of December 1931 to the 19th of January 1990. They forgot to mention his Samadhi. He was not given visas to 21 countries of the world. Almighty God coming in this world to visit the world and requires visas to go to different countries. And the Archbishop of Greece said, if you don't remove Rajneesh out of this country, we'll burn his house and the house of his disciples. And the last test, Valam Yakul Lahu Kufuwan Ahad, is so stringent that no one besides the true Almighty God can pass. The moment you can compare God to anything, he's not God. Valam Yakul Lahu Kufuwan Ahad. We know Rajneesh, like the human beings, had a beard, one nose, two eyes, two ears, two hands. The moment you can compare God to anything in this world, he's not God. Valam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. If someone says Almighty God is 1,000 times stronger than Arnold Schwarzenegger. Might have heard the name of Arnold Schwarzenegger. Have you heard Arnold Schwarzenegger? The person